Thank you. Mr. Carlos Queiroz, post-match press conference, and we'll start with your questions. And first question will be over here.
Commiserations on the loss, sorry. Can you tell us about the sending off, please? It looked like a bad decision from here. I know you've criticised the referee, Ben Williams, before. Should he have even been refereeing today?
Okay. I don't have many comments about Mr. Williams, because if I make comments today, I finish my career. And I don't think after 34 years of my career, you deserve that I finish my career here. So with the comments and everything I say, comes somebody behind and say, this is insulting. But let's review the facts, if you allow me. I never criticized the referee in the first game. The only thing I call attention in the first game was that the referee, all the referees, they should pay more attention to some specific actions of the games, specific the elbows, some disciplinary. This is, I did it in a polite way, good manners, including I said that the referees, they should be more proactive. For 100 years, this is not offending, this is not insulting, it's just a comment of a coach that have 33 years of coaching and have the right and have the duty to defend the physical integrity of the players. So this is the first point, I want to make it clear. Secondly, regarding today's game, I want to congratulate the Iraqi team for the way they play and the classification. I want also to congratulate my players, the Iranian players. They did everything that was possible to turn this game in our side. I am very proud for the way they play the game and the way they fight. But unfortunately, I cannot express my opinion about what happened, because if I do it, somebody say I'm insulting, they fire me, and I don't want to be in that position. So you tell me, don't ask me, you tell me your opinion. If the goalkeeper pushed one player, he pushed one player, you tell me, it's a question, I hope I'm not offending just because I question, if it is a correct decision to give a yellow card to the Iranian player. That's a question. I'm not offending, I'm not, I expect I'm not insulting nobody, I'm just saying that this decision is something that I would like to listen to opinion from the press. So don't ask me, please.
His comments, this gentleman from Al Borz newspaper, his comments are towards Mr. Queiroz, the respected head coach of Iran national team. He says, I don't think Mr. Queiroz or his team lost the game tonight. You have won the hearts of 75 million Iranians, as you did in the last three games. And with tonight's performance, every single Iranian is totally proud of you and your team. And you guys have done a fantastic job. On behalf of the nation, I want to congratulate you and your team.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
کمال سپاس رو از شما و از شما دارم.
Not a question. Okay. Question over here. Come on. Shit. Here. Look at me, okay? Look
at me. Carlos, good evening. Mani Jazmi, BBC. First of all, my deepest condolences and commiserations for the result. Carlos, what are you thinking right now? And do you think that penalty kicks are the best way to settle a draw in knockout competition?
Well, once again, you can imagine how I feel. But I cannot express how I feel. Because if I do it, if I say what I feel and if I tell the truth that everybody saw in the game, they come and they punish me and I finish my career. I don't want to do that. I don't want. I'm sorry, with all respect, I cannot express my feelings, because if I do that, I still want to play a couple of more games. But what I can say it is, first of all, congratulate to the Iraqi team. They qualified to the semifinals. And I want to say that the Iranian players, as well the fans, They are in my heart. The players today, they deserve all respect. They deserve all consideration from Iranian fans. Translate, I'll finish after. So, with all respect, my humble respect as a coach 34 years, humble respect, I apply to Sheikh Sultan, president of AFC, in your opinion, the press, you tell me, you make the judgment, not me, don't ask me to do that judgment, because once again, my comment in the first game was totally in manners, polite, but I'm charged because I insult or I offend somebody by Article 57. This is not correct, this is not something that is acceptable. Number two, we have a case with this referee. You tell me your opinion about this nomination. You tell me to play this game. Number three, you make the judgment of his work. Don't ask me, please, because if I give my opinion about Mr. Williams, I think I finished my career and I don't want to do that. So I don't mind to repeat this all night if you're still persisting making the same question.
Hammy from Press TV. Carlos, you and the team displayed a stunning performance tonight playing with only 10 players. Although the Iraqi team showed some good performance as well. There is no doubt within the media and also commentators, the referee made a poor, very poor judgment and the results were what it is right now. Now, moving on, I know everyone's upset. What is the future for the Iranian team? What have you got in mind for the Iranian team?
There is no football, there is no future without present. We must play the present and leave the present. Unfortunately, during the World Cup, everybody remember what happened in the game against Argentina. At the end of the day, Argentina, they played the final, which I think they deserved, and we went home. Today we go home. So in this moment, in our hearts, there is no future. It's just anger, just something that hurts a lot because the players, they work hard, they commit themselves. They deserve something more, respect, for sure, from the fans. And I think they have all my love and all my support because the way they fight during 120 minutes, I feel very, very proud to be a coach of this team and these players. And once again, I hope with all respect, as a humble person, I come from small town, from the bush to play this game, that the people in charge just make a judgment what happened today, because you tell me, not me, because I don't want to say it. If there is one person in this competition that understand this nomination, knowing that there is a case between the referee and the Iran national team, it's a question, it's not insult, it's a question. I hope to question is not offending. I hope so. So please answer to me, if there is one person sitting here in front that can understand this nomination for this game, one person. If there is, please explain to me, because I cannot understand.
Once again, Coach, we congratulate you for your team's performance tonight. All the boys fought very bravely. Everybody witnessed that on TV. His question is more or less regarded the last question. He says, your own future with the Iranian national team, because before the tournament start, you mentioned that in case the team doesn't qualify to the final, you perhaps will not continue, or you're going to suffer a bad situation with the Iranian national team. but the federation officials, they said it's regardless of what happens in the Asian Cup, you will continue as the head coach. What is the future with you and the Iranian national team?
Now, I really don't know. I really don't know. Sometimes you come to a moment in football that you don't know if it makes sense keep going in this this job. Congratulate the Iraqi team. They don't have nothing to do with this. They qualify. I wish them the best for the second round, for the semifinals. I just cannot be tired to repeat the same thing. Can he sleep tonight? I don't know. Just a question. Humble, if it is necessary, I put my knees on the ground to show my respect and my humble attitude. I put my knees down to ask him if how can we understand this decision? You tell me. But I want to emphasize this 1, 2, 3, 4 times. It's just a question. Just a question. I don't respect in front of the disciplinary committee of AFC. If it is necessary, I put my knees on the grass of football. But I ask you to make the judgment. You make the judgment. You make the judgment. Because we go home and wish the best to Iraq.
Of this match was 67 minutes and 32 seconds. The coach receives a thankful plaque of this campaign from AFC. Thank you, coach.
بازی اکتیو امشب 67 دقیقه و 30 ثانیه بود که سرمربی لوح تقدیر میگه.
If you don't mind, endorse this trophy to the referees. They deserve it more than me.
اشکالی نداره این رو بدیم به داورا به خاطر اتفاقی که امشب افتاد.
So we have the man of the match, number 15 from Iraqi team. It's Mr. Durkmar Ismail, and head coach of winning team tonight. It's Iraqi national football team coach, Mr. Radi Shneshil. So first two questions go to the man of the match, and then we'll let the player go back to his team, to the showers, and afterwards we'll continue with the coach. Maybe you can translate this, okay? So first two questions to the player.
Okay. السلام عليكم. أول سؤالين هو للكابتن برغام. بعدين هو لازم يطلع من المؤتمر.
Unless the player wants to stay for all.
Stay, how we go.
He will stay.
No, he wants to finish. He has to go.
He wants to go. Okay, yeah. Good. So first question, please, to the player. Okay, Valentino. It's on.
Valentino Migliaccio, sorry. From News Corp Australia. Congratulations on the victory tonight. I think in everyone's opinion, saying it was the best match of the Asian Cup tournament so far. Just with your own performance, I think you've been the most outstanding left back in this competition, the most outstanding defender. Would you ever consider coming to play in Australia?
سؤالك برغام يقول لك مبروك على الفوز اتوقع هاي كانت احسن مباراه بالبطوله لحد الان مباراه صعبه قدمته انت لحد الان تعتبر واحد من افضل اللاعبين في هذه البطوله في مركزك تتمنى ان تلعب باسترالي بالمستقبل
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والشكر قدمنا مباراه رائعه طبعا مو بس انا كافضل لاعب كل اللاعبين ساهموا بهذه الانجاز فمنتخب ايران منتخب قوي منتخب له طموح لكن منتخب العراق له طموح كثير ان شاء الله راح نكون مباراة المقبله اكثر حرص واكثر تقديم المستوى وان شاء الله اذا قلت ان انا اللي العب باستراليا ان شاء الله اللي كاتبه الله يصير وان شاء الله
Thank you for your question. You know, we worked hard, me and my teammates, to give something to our country. You know, all the respect to the Iraqi team. They're not an easy team. We played on the day. Now we're concentrating on our next match in the semis. You know, it's an important match. We've got to concentrate on that. Regarding my future, if it's in Australia, if God willing, you know, wants me to play in Australia, then it's in God's hands.
Thank you. And the second question goes there.
كابتن بارك لك على الفوز وشرفت الأمة العربية على الأداء والرجول والتأهل لنصف النهائي كلمنا عن المباراة من ناحية ركلة الجزاء ودي كانت مشكلة قدام منتخب العراق كابتن يونس ضيع مرتين مره في الودي ومره في الرسمي. كيف انت كابتن رضي اداك الثقه وسجلت ضربتين جزاء اليوم وادبت مستوى ولا اروع؟ وكيف تشوف هذا الفوز الكبير ورد فعله على الشارع العراقي؟
The question is to Dogram. Firstly, you know, he wants to congratulate him on the win. Regarding, you know, previously your team has lost two penalties by your captain Yunus, you know, in this competition and before. How did you build the confidence for the coach to choose you to take two penalties today? And so I don't
تعرف ان الثقه تجي من المدربين اكيد والحمد لله وشكر اعطوني ثقه كافيه لركله الجزاء والحمد لله وشكر قدرت ان بالدقيقه ما اعرف والله ايش قد بس بنهايه المباراه ان اركل الجزاء والحمد لله وشكر قدرت ان اسجل هدف رغم ان كثير قالوا لا تشوت يعني انت صغير بعدك خاف بس رغم ان اصراري وتعرف احنا العراقيين قلبنا ميت يعني ايه فالحمد لله وشكر قدرت الله يوفقني ووفق فريق ان شاء الله اكيد تعرف ان بلدنا هو محتاج الفرحه بهذا الوقت والحمد لله وشكر احنا يمكن لو غير منتخب ما راح يقدر يلعب بهاي الظروف اللي يمر بها بلدنا وشعبنا ما راح منتخب يقدر يقدم هذا المستوى ويقدم هذه الامكانيات الرائعه الحمد لله وشكر قدرنا ان نفرح شعبنا وهذا هو همنا الوحيد والاول اكيد وان شاء الله في المباراه القادمه نقدم مستوى رائع حتى نفرح شعبنا
Regarding the penalty, you know, the confidence came from the coaching staff, you know, during training. They're the ones that gave me confidence. You know, a lot of people said, I'm a young player, I should not be in that position where to, you know, take penalties. But thank God, you know, the confidence is there. Regarding the win, you know, our country needs the win. I don't think no other country can produce this quality or this positive result to their country. You know, we're going through a lot of problems in our country. We don't train or we don't play in our country. So thank God. Next match in the semis, it's a very important match. And we're there to bring the happiness to our country.
Lee Gaskin from Fairfax Media Australia. This question is for the coach. Coach, did you believe that the Iranian player deserved to be sent off in the first half?
سؤال للكابتن هل توقعت انه يستاهل اللاعب الايراني يكون له طرد بالمباراة؟
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم شكرا طبعا ما اعتقد انا اقدر يعني اللي عملنا هو حكم اللي هو يتخذ القرار حتى الحاله ما شفتها انا كنت يعني اتكلم مع الاخوه الكادر التدريبي بس انا اعتقد انه اليوم الفريق الايراني كان مشدود يعني رغم كان مسجل هدف المفروض يكون اهدى كان مشدود صراحه وانا اعتقد عاده ما الشد اذا في المصطبه الاحتياط يعني من الاداريين والمدربين ينتقل عاده الى الملعب الى الساحه فانا شاهدت اليوم فريق الايراني مو طبيعي يعني حد لو تلاحظ اكو حاله اللي صدم بها لاعبنا مروان مع الحارس دخلوا اللاعبين بدلاء وهاي الحاله يعني هاي يعني انا اعتبرها خطا وحتى سيء للبطوله يعني ممكن يصير يعني تاج ولاعبين يعني يتناوشون بالايدي صراحه فاليوم الفريق الايراني انا اعتقد انا شفت اليوم من اصعب الفرق صراحه الفريق الايراني لكنه التحكيم انا وجهه نظري عندي معلومات عن الحكم يشهر بطاقات كثيره وينتظر بعد جزاء كثيره وعندنا حتى احد الانديه في قطر نادي النجف فاز على نادي السد وطرد لاعبين انا اعتقد هو طبق روح القانون
Regarding the situation of the red card, to be honest with you, I was busy with my coaching staff. I didn't really concentrate on the, you know, on the situation. It's up to the referee makes the decision on the day. Regarding the Iranian team, I have all the respect for them. They're a strong team, but I reckon they were under pressure. The pressure came from the coaching staff, from their bench, which is wrong. That pressure implied on the players on the field, and you know they've scored a goal. They were leading 1-0. They should have been a bit more relaxed, especially there's a situation where one of our players with the goalkeeper, you know, Marwan, you know, there was an interaction between the goalkeeper and the player. You know, their players entered the field. I think this is even a bad reputation for the competition. So they should look into these things more. Regarding the referee, I know the referee very well. He's a type of referee that loves, you know, giving cards in situations, penalties. We've had him before in our Qatar League. So that's a stretcher for today.
بس ملاحظه حاولوا صراحه الفريق الان التهوا بالحكم ياثرون الحكم في سبيل ممكن يطرد احد اللاعبين اللي عندهم انذارات وكانت هي اكو بها الاحتكاك طبيعي يعني عادي فمو اي اي احتكاك ينطي كارت. اعتقد كان جل تفكيرهم بهذا الجانب ونسوا تقريبا المباراه، حاولوا قدر الامكان تكون كفه متعادله حتى بعدين يكون عندهم استراتيجيه اخرى.
I think the concentration after you know getting a red card for the team was to put pressure on the fourth official, you know, to give a, probably a red card or another card to any of the Iraqi players. They concentrated on these things, which is wrong. They should have concentrated on the match, and the referee, you know, gave all the yellow cards in the right you know situation tonight.
Thank you. Question here.
بداية أهني المنتخب العراقي وأهني الكابتن حقيقة على هذا الجهد الرائع، ونقدر نقول كانت من المباريات هذه جدا صعبة، وكانت مثل ما اتفقنا احنا وأستاذ علي أنه هي مباراة مجنونة. كنت أتمنى أهني هذا الفوز بتراجيديا عراقية بهالهولة، بس للأسف أنا ما أعرف حقيقة أهلهل. فبس للملاحظ كلنا لاحظنا من المدرجات كان فعلا مثل ما قال الكابتن انه اللاعبين والمدربين كلهم كانوا ينزلون للساحة. هنا أنا بس أنا أهني المنتخب العراقي تحديدا، وأنا التقطت صور حقيقة على الكياسة اللي كان يحملها العراق بشكل عام، أقصد المنتخب. فمرة أخرى ألف مبروك وشكرا زفية الفرح للعراق. شكرا.
Thank you.
Ahmed Abdul Karim.
Okay, the press conference is of the coach, not for you. Okay, next question over there.
Wait. Okay. طبعا شكرا جزيلا للأخت، وأنا أعتقد هذا واجب علينا. إحنا ما سوينا، أنا وجهة نظري شو نسوي للعراق، للشعب العراقي. أنا أعتقد بالنسبة لنا لا شيء، وجهة نظري غير متفضلين. وهي أنا أعتقد الميزة الإنسان أو اللاعب العراقي في هذا الظرف ويقف على قدميه وينافس الفرق ويتقدم عليهم، أنا أعتقد هذا جدا طبيعي إذا ترجعين إلى التاريخ. بصورة أو بأخرى أنا أعتقد لاعبينا قدموا مباراة جميلة، رغم أنه صحيح تراجيديا هي صارت، لكن أنا أعتقد تراجيديا في بعض بالنهاية تكون جميلة طبعا وتكون ممتعة.
Those greetings from Mrs. Wudad to the coach, and on the win, you know, and bringing the happiness to our country. The coach wants to thank her. You know, whatever we do for our country, it's not enough. You know, we got a positive result for our country, which we need. Regardless of what the country goes through, if you go back to the history of football, Iraq has been going through this situation always. So thank God, and thank you very much again.
Thank you. Question there.
نعم الرياض المرئي، نرحب بك كابتن راضي، والف الف الف مبروك. يعني هاي كلمه نقولها من كل الحاجات الموجودات بالعراق، وهاي قبله من الوالده يعني بعثتها خاصه الى كل المنتخب العراقي. الكل راهن على عدم مشاركه يونس محمود في هذه المباراه، لكن انت قلبت توقعات واشركته اربع اشواط وسجل اجمل هدفين اعتقد في تاريخ يونس محمود.
نعم.
يعني ما وردت يعني.
شكرا حبيبي. طبعا انا اعتقد المدرب اي كادر تدريبي عندما تكون عنده مباراه يجب ان يخطط للمباراه صراحه ويتعامل مع ادواته. انا اعتقد يونس اللي قاعد يؤدي، اكو انتقادات كثيره توجهت اني أنا اسمع اني، ورغم انه انا ما انزل على الفيسبوك صراحه، لان تعرف وجهات نظر مختلفه وهي وجهه نظر تبقى حتى تقدر تركيز. احنا نتعامل مع ادواتنا، ويونس له دور كبير صراحه في هذه الفتره. احنا عندنا مجموعه من اللاعبين الشباب اللي يحتاجون، مثل ما انا كنت لاعب شاب، واذا اشوف لاعبين القدامى حسين سعيد وعدنان درجال يكون عندي ثقه بنفسي. فاعتقد وجود يونس محمود في هذه الفتره وفي هذه البطوله مهم جدا، وتاثيره ايجابي حتى لو في بعض الاحيان هو غير جيد يعني، لكنه تواجده ياثر على الفريق الاخر سلبيا وعلى فريقنا ايجابيا. والدليل على ذلك انه اداءه بدا يتصاعد، يعني احنا كنا صراحه نخاف فقط من الجاهزيه، انه انا تفاجئت به، كنت مرشحه انه اطلعه بالتمديد، لكن من شاهدته بقيناه صراحه. فاقول شكرا للاخ يونس طبعا على المجهود الكبير اللي قدمه، وان شاء الله بعد يستمر فتره طويله، وهو نجم صراحه يستحق كل احترام وتقدير.
The question was regarding, there's a lot of people that had doubt that Yunus will play this match due to the performance he's been giving in the competition. And he scored probably the worst two beautiful goals today during the match. The answer for the coach is, there was a lot of doubt from people, and people have a point of view. You know, I don't go on social media and listen to these things. I've got a, you know, I'm a coach. I see what the player produces during the, you know, training time. Today, I think he played four halves. He was amazing. He scored two goals. You know, we have a young young squad where we need a leader. You know, I was a young player where when I used to see stars like, you know, Mr. Hussein Saeed in front of me, it gives me the positive feedback. He's a person that gives a negative, feedback to the opponent, but a positive feedback to his teammates. So I want to thank him for his performance tonight. I wish him all the best, and he's a star for our country.
Thank you. And due to the, we're running out of time, okay? We have only 15 minutes for this press conference, so I'll give two more questions, okay?
Thank you. طبعا كابتن راضي شكرا جزيلا. قبل هاي المباراة قلنا لك انت وصلت الانجاز واليوم نقول لك انجاز اخر مسيرتك كمدرب. رسالة للشعب العراقي هذا اللي قدمت له الفرحة اللي اكبر السياسيين ما قدروا يقدمون هاي الفرحة له. سؤالي هو الحالة العصبية اللي اجتي مع اللاعب علي عدنان، نعرفك انت كلك، انا متابعك من قبل لحد الان، نعرفك شوي عصبي بالملعب، شلون راح نتعالج هاي السالفة كابتن؟ شكرا جزيلا.
شكرا لله بارك لك. طبعا لا شكر على واجب. حالة رد فعل طبيعي لانه صراحة من لعبنا كنت اتوقع ينطي اكثر صراحة، فشفته يعني شوي بعيد عن التركيز. فهنا اللاعب في بعض الأحيان ردود أفعال المدرب تحسس بحجم المسؤولية وليس انتقاص من اللاعب، العكس علي عدنان من اللاعبين الجيدين اللي لهم دور كبير، لكنه من خلال تواجده كان بتلك الفترة رغم أنه نقص أنا كنت أتوقع يعني أنه يكون أداء أكثر وأفضل، لكن كان بعيد شوي عن التركيز. المهم أنا قاعد عندي قاعدة معاه، بالعكس انتهت الحالة وقبلته ما كان أي مشكلة. أولاً أنا مثل أخوهم ليس فقط وكالة التدريب، وأتعامل معهم تعامل أخوي عادل، خصوصاً بالجانب الفني، الجانب الإنساني كلهم أخواني، ما عندي أي مشكلة صراحة معهم.
The question was to the coach regarding, you know, firstly, you've put another star into your history of coaching, you know, reaching the semifinals. The question was, you know, we've seen a few angry moments between you and the player Ali Adnan. The coach's answer was, Ali was a sub, you know, I expected a better performance from him. You know, sometimes when you see a coach angry on the player, it's not because he doesn't like him or he's not performing, it's just to show him how much responsibility he should have during the match, you know, to show him his responsibility. I'll be sitting with him and talking to him, you know, the anger's over. They're all like my brothers. Doesn't matter if I'm a coach, I treat him as a family. We're all one family and they're all like my brothers.
This is already 1 hour after the match, you know. We need to let the coach go to celebrate. So last question, and he had his hand up first. Sorry for that. You can, yeah, you go first row.
Coach, congratulations on the win. You've got South Korea and Sydney in the semi-finals. Are you confident after the game you put out today that you can go on and beat South Korea and make the final?
هتلاقي كوريا في نصف النهائي، فتتوقع أنه بعد النتيجة اليوم والأداء هتتوقع أنه تقدر تغلبهم وتصعد للنهائي؟
Thank you. والله أولاً طبعاً أهم شيء أنه نرجع وضع اللاعبين صراحة، لأن اليوم لعبنا اكسترا تايم، فهذا اثر طبعا بدين على اللاعبين. فريق الكوري من الفرق المميزه ومرشحه طبعا مع الفريق الاسترالي وكذلك الفريق الياباني، لكن اتمنى طبعا ان يكون اللاعبين جاهزين فقط لائقين بدنيا يعني بالمباراه، لانه حقيقه صار مباراتين احنا نكون ضحيه انه نلعب في يومين ونرتاح والفرق الاخرى تجينا فرق يوم، وهذا يؤثر على اللاعبين صراحه. فلكنه انا ثقتي كبيره باللاعبين، مع جل احترام وتقدير فريق الكوره فريق خطر، نحاول قدر الامكان انه نتعامل مع المباراه تعامل تكتيكي يليق بالمباراه ان شاء الله.
Regarding that question, you know, our main goal now is recovery. I think Korea, Australia, or Japan are, you know, they are teams that are there to win the Asian Cup. I think, you know, this is the second time we've fallen in this disadvantage. You know, the first time with Iran, where we had 1 day less of recovery. Now again, we have 1 day less of recovery. You know, we played four halves. So the most important thing now for our players is to recover, and hopefully we can produce something for our country.
And a special request from the coach to extend the press conference for one question, and he asks Rashida to you have a chance to ask a question.
Yeah, because she was upset.
Sorry again. This is a question to the coach. Just following on, the last time you played South Korea was in 2009, so it was quite a while back, and that was a friendly where South Korea won. You mentioned that your main focus is recovery, but you know, can you be confident of beating South Korea having clinched this win?
Have you been confident?
Confident.
Okay. سؤال للكابتن يقول لك انه اخر مباراه بينه وبين كوريا كانت بال 2009 وخسرنا بهذه المباراه وتفت اهتمامك انه اللاعبين ترجعهم لمستواهم بهذه الفتره القصيره الثلاث ايام فتتوقع انه بعد النتيجه اليوم والاداء انه تتوقع انه انت قادرين انه على الفوز مع كوريا
شكرا طبعا حظوظ الفرق اللي تأهل الأربعة أنا أعتقد هي كلها حظوظ متساوية وتلاحظ أنا أنتم أعتقد ما يغيب عنكم الناو الدور الربع النهائي والسيمي فاينل مختلف جدا الأداء شوف اللاعبين يعني وأدام لأنه فرصة واحدة هي خروج المغلوب فأعتقد أنه الفريق الكوري يحترم الفريق العراقي صاحب التاريخ كبير وعندنا نتائج متميزة معهم أتمنى طبعا أنه نوفق نحن وكذلك اللاعبين في تقديم مستوى طيب مع الفريق الكوري فريق خطر حقيقة عندنا لاعبين جيدين أنا عندي لاعبين اثنين موجودين في نادي قطر عندنا كمحترفين ففريق أغلبه لاعبين محترفين خارج كوريا بصورة أو بأخرى نعتقد الحظوظ متساوية الأربع فرق اللي تتأهل
I think the four teams now in the semi-finals have all the same luck, you know, getting to these stages. You know, the quarterfinals is different to the semi-finals, these kind of matches. Korea, I think they respect Iraq. There's a lot of history. There's a lot of positive results from Iraq against Korea. I think, you know, we respect them. They're not an easy team. I've got two Korean players actually that play with me in the club. You know, they have a lot of professional players that play outside Korea. It's not an easy match, but hopefully we can do the job on the day.
Thank you. And as no surprise, this match was played for more than 60 minutes. Yeah, you all noticed that. And the actual playing time was 67 minutes and 32 seconds. So this plaque goes to the coach as a thank you note from the 16 minutes, don't delay, play campaign. Thank you.